I wonder what was wrong with me. People say I took to my bed with an illness, but I don't recall. I remember meeting with a bamboo seller named Kaguya, and I remember a secret treasure for crossing a sea of fire. But I've totally lost my memory of what happened after that. It's almost like I was possessed by a strange spirit. Bah, talk about a troublesome emperor. But Kaguya's safe and all. I guess we can cut him some slack. A white wolf, and a curious bouncing ball. I have an uncanny feeling that I had a dream about you two. I must apologize to Queen Himiko for my unforgivable blunders. Himiko? Yes, that's it, Ami. This city's a complete mess, and Queen Himiko's not doing a thing about it. There's no excuse for her just sitting around in her palace. Boy, am I gonna give her a piece of my mind. Ah, the lovely white wolf. For some reason, I seem to feel so relaxed when you're around. I have this peaceful feeling, as if you know me inside out. Oh, I know you from the inside, believe me. I'm collecting demon fangs, you know. If you have any for me, you can take some of my treasure. People will probably say I'm foolish giving treasure to a wolf, but you're my lucky wolf. I'm certain some good will come of it. Surely you've collected lots of them, eh? What do you think? Would you like to make a swap? Sure, I definitely will make use of your treasure hoard. Right off at the very top of the list is the item that the game is obviously telling you that you should purchase, the Fog Pot. It's marked with a wind crest and allows you to warp between origin mirrors. Super useful! Think of how many Mermaid Springs, which is the lesser version of this technique, think of how many Mermaid Springs we've seen so far. Maybe four, five tops? Think of how many origin mirrors there are. An origin mirror is a save mirror that has an X on it. We've probably seen maybe 10 to 15 by now, and there's at least one in every area, and if there isn't, it's within like 1 minute's walking distance from the area you want to go to. This is amazing, and I will be purchasing this for 80 yen, or not yen, sorry, 80 demon fangs. But first, I would like to scroll down to the bottom of the list, because while you might think at first glance that what you see here is the Fog Pot is the only new item, that's wrong. They put some new items at the bottom of the list, which is kind of strange. I mean, I don't really get why they would do that, but hey, I won't question it that much. There's the Thieves' Glove, which basically allows us to use the technique that we've made use of when we were shrunken down in the Imperial Palace. It allows us to draw a line from Isun to an opponent, an enemy, to steal an item from them, whether that be some treasure that we can sell, or I believe a consumable like a Holy Bone M, or, I don't know, an Exorcism Slip L, not L, sorry, S, or something like that. And it does damage as well, and each consecutive time you use it, it becomes more powerful. So that's pretty useful. It's sort of like a brush technique that you can equip. And then lastly is the item, oh my word, I want this item so badly. Ink Pot with Golden Sheen increases ink restoration speed. The Golden Ink Pot makes it so your ink regenerates faster. Who'd have thunk it? Because it's just, I just said increases ink restoration speed. This is super useful because it increases the speed of it. So it's basically giving you a ton of extra ink pots. Every now and then in battles, I'll run short on ink, but that'll probably never happen with this equipped. And even if I do, the time it takes for my ink to be restored and my godhood and weapons to be restored to me will be like halved or thirded. I don't know. But yeah, but sadly, I don't want to get this quite yet. I would like to purchase the Fog Pot, because that will come in very handy, and we'll only need 11 more Demon Fangs to get the Golden Ink Pot. But anyway, we get a second power of Drunk Sheep. Matarazu, origin of all that is mother and good mother to us all. Our separation had weakened me. My power had scattered like mist. Your heart, pure enough to pierce the darkness, reawaken me. The seal of mist will protect you. My power has reached the top of the mountain's top notch. I hereby bestow upon you the power of warp of mist. Bah. Can I sleep this off now? Whoa, never expected something like that from a flask. What are you talking about? When we got Veil of Mist, we got it from a flask. Bet that Royal Oof didn't even know what was in this thing. Now, about Mist Warp. I don't know exactly how to use it, but the important thing is you got another technique back. And a chest to go along with it. What treasures can be in this chest? Stray beads? Sand fragments? Gold dust? Or treasure that's worth 100,000 million yen? Find out! It's just a scroll explaining how to use Mist Warp. So I guess I should introduce this episode proper since we've been going about 5 minutes without me actually telling you guys who I am, in case you first visited the channel. So, intro, away! Hey guys and gals, I'm Pal, and welcome back to Okami. Last episode, we defeated Blight, the source of the mist that had been plaguing the city of Seon. This episode, we're hopefully going to head to Queen Himiko's palace in the hopes of confronting her about her lackadaisicalness, is that even a word? Concerning the people's plight. So, that's what we're going to be doing. But first, like I said, I cannot afford the golden ink pot, which is extremely sad. I'm so sad about that, but... So I will be actually waiting. We can afford the thieves glove, but I don't want to get that, really, yet. I feel like the golden ink pot is just a higher priority right now, so I'll be waiting till I have 11 more demon fangs to purchase that, and then we'll work on getting the thieves glove. So anyway, while we do this, I would like to do this, whatever we're doing. Great commentary, pal. While we are waiting for it to become night, because you can see that there is a buried chest right there. However, I want to wait to nab that, because I want to wait for it to be night, so you guys can see all of the treasure chests scattered about. But while we do that, I would like to explain a couple of things. I know, it's been a long time, well, it's been a very good number of episodes since I've last went on a tangent explaining some reference to mythology or a story or Dogu or something like that, and I like to do that. I like to waste your guys' time explaining Japanese culture because apparently I'm obsessed with it. And I'm sorry, but for a brief moment when it showed that guard in the end of day sequence, it looked like a fee. where my mind goes sometimes. I would like to explain the Doom Mirror. Because that is a very, very interesting enemy. It's a reskin of an enemy that we've seen thus far, the Ice Lips / Fire Eye, but it's interesting because these have a slight reference to, not mythology, but symbolism, rather. I'll be reading these off in the order that they appear. The Thunder Doom Mirror. It doesn't have any significance. Yeah, this is a great way to start this off. It does not have any significance, nor does the picture on it have any symbolism at all. But that's cool, because when I explain all the other mirrors, it will make the Thunder Doom Mirror sound really, really, really neat. So let me go ahead and go on to the others, and then I'll go back to the Thunder Doom Mirror. The Wind Doom Mirror has an old man's face, and its manipulation of wind may be linked to its background. Apparently, the old man's face on it reminds people who waste time, people who whittle time away, playing video games, that if they continue to waste time, they'll regret their misuse of it, and then they'll only realize that they wasted it until they're older, thus showing the old man. I'll probably be putting pictures on screen to show you guys what these faces look like, so you guys can kind of picture what I'm talking about. The Fire Doom Mirror. It's really cool, because we've seen the entire series of Doom Mirrors, so I get to explain all of these. The Fire Doom's Mirror is a background of a man who's very, very angry, and because it's a fire element, which that seems to symbolize anger, because fire is typically associated with anger or wrath or vengeance, so it symbolizes anger. Finally, the Ice Doom Mirror, and then we'll be going back to the Thunder. The Ice Doom Mirror's background of an actress. Now, that's kind of strange, because ice, actress, don't really go together, but it's an actress trying to preserve her beauty. Think of it, it's a mirror. What are mirrors used for? Mirrors are used to look at yourself in them. So an actor trying to preserve her beauty for an eternity, which ties into the ice because she's trying to be frozen, and I didn't get to show what I got to show because all of nighttime just passed. So that's really, really neat. So she's trying to keep herself frozen in a state of youth forever. That's just really cool. The ice doom mirror probably has the deepest of all symbolisms. But back to the thunder doom mirror. It doesn't have any symbolism, which I found really, really out of place. Like, it was just, it felt off to me. Like, it felt like there is, it's just my research, or the researchers hadn't seen anything. So I thought about it for a while, and I came up with the fact that the Thunder Doom Mirror is random. It symbolizes chance or randomness, because if you think about it, it just on it is like a picture of some random guy's face, and it is thunder. Thunder rarely, I'm not going to say never, because it does every now and then, it rarely strikes in the same place twice under normal conditions. And that kind of ties in with the fact that it's random. It's just out of the blue. You never expect it. So that's its tie-in. There. I'm proud of myself for doing this. And now that my rant is out of the way, it's not actually over. I know, son of a gun, pals on a tangent. But I'll go ahead and dig these up while I'm explaining this. This is a stray beat, I just want to point that out. So, I've been waiting for 42 episodes now to explain Isun's reference to mythology. The reason why I've been waiting this long is because if I had told you the story, it would have spoiled Blight. I know, the Blight is sort of in his reference to mythology. And also, I hope you're appreciating how many chests are all over this area. We're stealing royal funds. So Isun is based on the story of Isun Boshi, which I believe translates something along the lines of the one-inch boy. Why can't I dig this up? The tale begins with an old childless couple. The elderly wife wishes for a child, no matter how small he could be. Eventually, a son is born to them. But the son was very, very small, no larger than a grown man's fingertip. They named him Isun Boshi. The child, even though he was so small, he got along surprisingly well with his parents, until one day he realized he would never grow, so he decided to go on a trip to seek his place in the world. Thinking himself a samurai, Isun Boshi was given a sewing needle for a sword, a soup bowl for a boat, and chopsticks for oars. He sailed downriver to a city, where he petitioned for a job. He ended up getting one as a playmate to a princess. While they traveled together one day, they were attacked by an oni. Oni means demon. The oni deals with Isun by swallowing him. But Isun, with a lot of bravery, defeats the oni by stabbing him from within with his sword. The oni spits out Isun and drops the... pardon me for butchering this pronunciation... Uchide's mallet? As he runs away. As a reward for his bravery, the princess uses the power of the mallet to grow him to full size. Isun and the princess remain close and eventually wed, living happily ever after. Best end to a story. And the Uchide's mallet is actually referenced in this game as the Lucky Mallet. So the Lucky Mallet is in Isun's story. So there you go. That is Isun's story. It contains a reference to Blight, the Lucky Mallet, and Seon City. There you go. There's the story. Albeit kind of stuttered, but hey, I'm doing this live commentary, so I hope you guys are proud of me and not crying. Okay, with that out of the way, I have no more explanations to explain. I have no more references to symbolism or mythology or anything, circuses. So I'm taking my paper that had all the information on it and turning it upside down and leaving it alone, because it is now time to leave this place and go over to Himiko's palace. Let us tobacco sauce. Oh, there's no loading screen right here. That's awkward. Loading screen here. It's kind of... Oh, never mind. The game interrupted me. Hiya, bamboo girl. What are you doing spacing out here? I mean, you're free now. You could go anywhere you want. Oh, hello, you two. I hardly recognize you. You were so tiny when we first met. Well, Isun actually hasn't changed size. You certainly cut a dashing figure at full size. Oh, she's talking to me. You think so? Well, actually, I hear stuff like that all the time. Huh? Oh, yes. I meant you too, Isun. Anyway, Good way to brush that one off. The city is a dangerous place right now. You should head back to your grandpa's house. That emperor fellow's got an eye for that treasure of yours, right? You should get away before others start sniffing around. Plus, your grandpa seems awfully lonely, you know. Really? Oh, I see. That dear old man thinks of me as his own granddaughter. I would really like to return, but... You're not his granddaughter? You mean your real family lives somewhere else? Anyway. You should just go see him if you feel that way. I know nothing of my past. I don't even know who I am or where I came from. My first memory is of waking up in a bamboo grove. The bamboo cutter took me home, where I was lovingly cared for. To repay his kindness, I helped him with his bamboo ware. If that's the case, then why don't you hurry up and go see him? I know nothing of my past, but I do recall one faint memory. I thought long and hard while I was imprisoned. It was then that I remembered being in a small, dark room long ago. That's all I can think about now. And I feel I must get there as soon as I can. I cannot escape that feeling. That's a pretty weird story. I mean, you don't even know where it is that you want to go back to. Bits and pieces of my memory are coming back in flashes. Together they form a vision. I see a royal crest inscribed in earth amid a grove of bamboo. I must go to Sasa Sanctuary. There, it shall all become clear. Eastern Nippon, we know where that is. We know where Sasa Sanctuary is, but I believe the game is doing this to point out the fact that we now have the Fog Pot and Mist Warp, so we can actually just warp straight to Sasa Sanctuary without having to spend 2,000 yen to buy a mermaid coin. Very helpful. Huh? What's gotten into you? I mean, first with the dark room, and now you suddenly want to go to Sasa Sanctuary? I don't know to where I must return, but I have this intense feeling in my heart. It drives me forward to my ultimate destination. It drives me to seek the royal crest. I must leave for Sasa Sanctuary at once. Man, you're a slow runner. Hey, wait, Bamboo Girl, wait. Oh, she's gone. How could she be gone? She was running like half a mile per hour. I could have done this and caught up with her. How could she move that fast off camera? I don't know. Let's see. Treasure chests, maybe? No, I've already checked this area. So, let's go ahead and head over to Himiko's palace, because I want you guys to get some semblance of progress this episode, even if it is just going to those guards and seeing that we cannot pass even still. Stupid guards. Let me pass. You're a persistent one, aren't you, mutt? For whatever reason, the curse seems to have dissipated. There's still a sinister presence on the Ryushima coast, though. But we won't let it lay a finger on Queen Himiko. No, we guards won't let any evil get the better of us. Himiko's parrots all sound like a bunch of people. Maybe they can stand up to the evil of those monsters, but I bet they're no match for the brush techniques of the gods. We've already tried all of them. Oh, wait. Holy stars above, Batman! Their stars aren't actually holy, but stars above, Batman even still. We have Veil of Mist, so we can run around at the speed of light and just run right through and leave those guys behind, not even seeing where we went. We're just a white blur with an orange, awesome streak on our back. Actually, wait, I just thought of something. We have a new weapon. I forgot about that. We have the exorcism beads. So let's go and equip those and equip 7 Strike as our sub and then immediately go and upgrade the exorcism beads. There we are. And now we can exit. And you guys can see the beautiful green exorcism beads. I feel the need to point out that they're green because I believe in the cutscene where we got them. Also, it is nighttime. In the cutscene where we got them, I don't think they were green. I think that they were brown, which is weird, but I could be wrong. But anyway, all the way back here behind the palace is a chest that contains a stray bead. Second stray bead this video. Okay, let's go ahead and go around because for symmetry's sake, there's bound to be a chest on the other side in the symmetrical, also secret area. You could just go over here, take a sharp left, jump over the lamp thing, take a right, and where it looks like it's a dead end here, you actually turn left and left. And there's not a chest, but there is a clover that probably contains 400 praise, because this is the secret clover. This is the one that I could only get if I... No. Okay. It's just 10 praise. So sad. Let's see. We can go up to Himiko's palace, which I probably should have pointed out. Although, really, there's stairs here. I didn't really need to point it out. Okay. Instead of going in the front entrance, let's go off the beaten path. And can we go in there? Wait, we can. We can go in here. And there's a Daruna statue. Neat. With a godly charm. I will take that, and a chest containing a crystal. Okay. I'm really glad I went in here. A koto and a shamisen. What an elegant room. But it looks like it's just used for storage now. That's kind of... I guess I've noticed this before, but... Wait, let me leave before I continue talking. Whenever we see a shamisen, we're able to examine it. Like, except for the ones that the imps carry, whenever we see one, we are actually able to examine it, and Isun always makes a comment about it. I wonder if someone in the dev team plays a shamisen, or just really appreciates their music, because, seriously, all the shamisens in this game, it's not just like they're a theme, like, I don't know, paper fans. It's something that whenever we see it, Isun makes a comment about it, which leads me to believe that they actually have more of significance than they actually do. Maybe I should check that out. I should really check that out, like, on the wikis, because that's where I do all my Okami research about shamisen, see if there's a reference. Oh, and the koto, or what I like to call gong, it actually glangs. Listen to that. That'd be a really cool mod for, like, Smash Brothers, or on a certain stage, if when you're about to fight, like, it would go 3, 2, 1, go! That'd be really cool. Random thoughts. Also, why is Amaterasu not in Smash Brothers? Like, if Amaterasu is in Smash Brothers, I would want to buy Smash Bros. For, like, every single one of you guys, just so you could play me with Amaterasu online. Okay, there's one place we have yet to check, Smash Brothers aside, and it is behind the... Oh, this is the front. behind the palace. There we are. We have a chest back here, which contains a Holy Bone M. Pretty nice. I'll take it. It's better than those dumb Holy Bone S's. Those things are useless now. And this, which has no significance at all right now. Maybe later it'll do something, but for now, it's just a pool of water. But you want to remember it for later. Remember any pool of water you see. Well, here we are. There's very little security inside the palace. Why? It really is you. Her Majesty Queen Himiko has foreseen your coming. You must not delay. Please, Queen Himiko waits on the top floor. Himiko's waiting? For us? Oh my word, exorcism beads look amazing. If you're really the ones Queen Himiko's been looking for, even a boiling sea of flames won't stand in your way, will it? I don't know. That's a really weird question to ask. It's like, picture if I walked up to you. I'm talking to you, viewer. Imagine if I walked up to you on the street. You don't know my face, because you guys don't know what my face looks like, because I've never posted that on social media. I walk up to you and say, "Hey, can you walk through a sea of flames? Well, tell me now, because it'll determine whether or not I'm your friend." Like, that's the randomest question to ask. Oh, and also I'm loitering by this chest to point out that it is a stray bead. The third stray bead in the video! Oh my word, it's making editing so hard for Future Pal, because me, Past Pal, I love being a jerk to you, Future Pal. I am pointing straight to you, Future Pal. Try and make a rebuttal for that. I make your job hard. Anyway, let's go ahead and go in the elevator, which is automatic, and it will bring us to the top floor. You guys probably thought we were going through some sort of new dungeon to reach the top floor. All Die Hard style, which I'm not even sure if they're elevators or floors in Die Hard, because I don't really have watched Die Hard ever. We're going to go to the top with no dungeons involved and go through the door into, oh my word, lava. Whoa. What the world? What's with all this lava doing here? You may be a god now, but you'll end up a crispy critter if you fall into this stuff. That Himiko is sure making things difficult. She must really have a good reason for wanting to keep people away. Now that lava comment makes sense. And if I ever invited you guys over to my house after you saying that you could survive a pit of lava, it actually wouldn't do anything because I don't have a pit of lava. But man, lava, how on earth? Okay, this is one of those things where I must question gaming logic. This is the top floor of a palace. A palace made of wood. How on earth? No, where on earth? Where on Nippon, can you get wood that resists lava? Because I really want that wood. Like, I really would love to coat a volcano with them trees and make houses that would withstand lava. Man, that would be very cool. But other than that, like, lava, really. Best security system in the world. I don't even know why they have those guards outside, because what are they going to do that lava can't? I don't know, maybe if we had, like, the cheats we could get through. But sadly, since we can't progress the story, that's going to be it for this LP. I'm just going to have to wait till they release the DLC that allows us to drain lava or bottle lava, and that's going to be it. Thank you guys so much for watching this LP, and the episode's not over, neither is the LP, so let's go. Before we leave, or before I end it off, we actually have a lot more to do, because it is a Saturday, and you guys know what Saturdays mean. They usually mean not long episodes, because I constantly forget, or I constantly misjudge when an episode's supposed to take place in real time. But this time I'm not. I remember that it's Saturday. Also, if it is not if this episode does not come out on Saturday, Future Pal has just gotten his revenge for me taunting him. Okay, where is an origin mirror? Because we do not actually want to explore the restored Saiyan City just yet. Also, I would like to point out that it is restored. But instead, I would like to go to the nearest origin mirror and warp to Sasa Sanctuary. BRB, LOL. I will meet you guys there. Welcome to Saiyan City. Sweet. The curse zone vanished along with that funky mist. Looks like the city has come back to life. Ami, bet you never saw a happening place like this 100 years ago. This must be exciting for you, being from the country and all. Now, I know you just want to have fun, but don't go overboard. I mean, I don't want you to forget what you're supposed to be doing. Neither do I, because we're not going to be looking at any of this area. I'll focus on the ground, because this is a bad place. Don't you look at it. We're not going to be exploring with this or listening to the amazing music. Until next episode, we're going to Kusa Village. Okay, I was able to warp straight to Sasa Sanctuary from Ryushima Coast, because there are no origin mirrors in Saiyan City, which is really, really stupid. Like, it is legit stupid. But anyway, I would like to run through here and go to the bamboo grove at the upper right corner of the map, which is our destination, so we can see what on earth Kaguya has been talking about. Okay, let's just go and run to the end of the passage. We've been here before, so this is nothing new. And you might have noticed that I did not use Mist Warp, because I'll be showing you guys how to do it when we warp out of here. Okay, with that out of the way, let's enter the grove, which is up here even further. Here we are. There are a couple people here. The gods be praised. Is it really you, Kaguya? I never thought I'd see you again after the Emperor suddenly summoned you to Saiyan City. Kaguya, dear Kaguya. It feels like ages since we last met, Grandfather. My, look at all those new wrinkles. Have I worried you so? Oh, Grandfather. I thought you guys would run into each other here. I'm happy for you two. Oh, Kaguya, let us live together happily ever after. We could sell my bamboo ware, just you and me. Well, that's not creepy at all. Oh, what's wrong, Kaguya? Do you have to return to the Emperor? No, that's not it. It's just... I cannot live without you, Grandfather. Huh? Huh? What are you talking about, Kaguya? And she said, I cannot live with you. Sorry, my bad. You're not eloping or running away from something, are you? I didn't know you were here, Grandfather. It would have been better if we had not met before I departed. Departed? Where are you going? I'm not sure. The royal crest carved into the earth here in Sasa Sanctuary. It calls to me. What the? Kaguya, what are you doing? It's as if I'm being driven by some invisible force. Below this crest, far below the earth, something linked to my mysterious past awaits. I must go. I must see what lies within this hole. Kaguya! Kaguya! No, don't do it, Bamboo Girl. It's too dangerous. After her, Ami. Okay, I won't complain about the digging minigame again. I'll just get it over with. Kaguya, get over here. It's not like I don't know how to do this. Kaguya, this way, girl. Good girl. Okay, let me just go ahead and mash the C button with my other finger, not my actual finger that I should be using. Okay, run and jump. Let's do this. I need to escort her now. There we go. And let's go this way because it's easier. I really don't need to explain anything that hasn't been explained before. So let's just get this over with. Power slash. And will she get over here soon? Man, the golden ink pot would be super... Oh, that was close. Super useful right now. Like, I am almost out of ink. And the problem with the with Gale Storm is that you don't start regaining ink again until... Where am I? Oh, no. Really? Oh, never mind. Derp. Derp-da-derp, skirp. I panicked for no reason. What I should be using right here is this. But what I was saying is that you don't start regaining ink until after Gale Storm's entirety is done, which is really inconvenient. Like, it's super inconvenient for you, because if you're low on ink, you know, that's not good. Also, 2 for the price of 1. I wish that was 3 for the price of 1, but hey, okay. This is a very, very extensive trial. Let's just do that. Get some money. Jump. Come here, Kaguya. Come on, girl. Good girl. Don't drown. Fly up in the air. Good girl. Okay. We are almost to the end. Hopefully. Just let me mash the C button here with my thumb this time. There we go. I'm doing well. And, of course, I hit it. Power slash. I hit it again because I was holding the Wii remote backwards. And run, Kaguya, run. Run like the wind. There we go. Good girl. Let's go. You found what you're looking for? So have I. At least that was very painless. Do 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 ho 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 ho, Bamboo Girl. What in the world? Looks like a bamboo shoot, except it's metal and insanely huge. Okay, I'll stop with my alien theme. This is what was calling me. It was the link to my mysterious past. Kaguya, I knew that this giant bamboo shoot was buried here in Sasa Sanctuary. You did? But one day, many years ago, I came here to cut down some bamboo. Suddenly, this giant bamboo shoot appeared right before my eyes. Your cold and nearly lifeless body came tumbling out. Then, this giant bamboo shoot disappeared back into the ground. You were as cold as ice and looked like you might die at any minute. I quickly picked you up and rushed home. My dearly departed wife and I nursed you back to health. We had always wanted a child. You were like a blessing from the heavens. You brought joy into our lives. I couldn't tell you the truth. I feared that if you found out, you would seek out this strange bamboo shoot. I feared that it would take you away from us forever. Don't go. Don't go, Kaguya. Grandfather. Sob. First time we've ever heard or seen Isun cry. I always thought of you and our dearly departed grandmother as my real family. And that feeling shall never fade. Though I may leave, my heart remains with you. Remember that. But I cannot stay here with you. A mysterious force is calling me. I cannot resist. I must discover where it came from. Don't worry, I will come back to you. I just need to know. So, I beg of you, oh grandfather dear, see me off with a smile on your face. Okay. I will, Kaguya. Go wherever you may. I only ask that when you get there, you remember one thing. You are my precious grandchild. Never forget that. You are my dearest, most precious grandchild. Oh, grandfather. His precious grandchild. Huh? I wasn't thinking about home or anything. No, really. Isun, Amaterasu, I am forever grateful to you. I could never thank you enough for what you did for me. But please, accept this as a token of my appreciation. You obtained Fire Tablet! It was my sole link to my mysterious past, but now that I'm returning home, I shall need it no longer. May it help you in your travels. It is time. Time for me to depart. Thank you, you two. Thank you, Grandfather. Farewell, and may we meet again someday in another life. Well, it's gone. Wonder where it's headed. I hope that bamboo girl has a safe journey wherever it leads. Hey, Ami, get the lead out. We got sidetracked helping that bamboo girl. Let's get going. We have work to do. We gotta rake that queen over the coals. She's got some explaining to do. She is Lucy Ricardo. Kaguya, she's gone. So that giant bamboo sprout was a cradle to take her home. My prayers are with you, dearest Kaguya. Well, the royal crest in the middle of the grove is gone, as is any trace that Kaguya ever existed, except for the one fire tablet. The one thing that we need to access Queen Himiko is now ours, and we didn't even have to ask for it. That will be it for this episode. Kaguya has a very, very deep reference to mythology, but I will not explain it because, at least not yet, because, first of all, we're out of time, but there's some other reasons. I have to see if the story actually contains spoilers, so I might explain it next episode, but if it contains spoilers, I will tell you guys that it does, so you guys just don't think I forgot to tell you. Okay, that'll be it for this episode. I release new episodes of Okami Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Saturdays. Saturdays are long episodes. And if you like this episode, comment. If you didn't like this episode, then comment and tell me how I can make next episode so that you would like it. Next time in Okami, I already said. So, see you guys next time.